Secret Tunnels of Orthodox Jews Found Under New York. An attempt to protect underground passages resulted in clashes with the police and arrests. In early December, a secret tunnel was discovered in New York, leading to the main synagogue of the Jewish religious movement Chabad Lubavitch in Brooklyn. The Crown Heights regional newspaper reported this. A local resident told reporters that he heard suspicious sounds at night. The building, located at 770 Eastern Boulevard, is considered the world headquarters of the organization, which welcomes thousands of visitors each year, including international students and religious leaders. The synagogue previously served as the home of the head of the Hasidic movement in the 1940s, Yosef Yitzhak Schneerson, over the years. Additional buildings were erected on the site as the movement grew in size. After the tunnel was discovered, the synagogue's leadership called in civil engineers to fill in the secret underground passages. However, on Monday, January 8th, a group of young people began to protest and defend the tunnel. Someone called the police, after which clashes broke out between her and the Orthodox youth. Chabad Lubavitch headquarters in New York, January 9, 2024. Photo, Lokman Viral Elibal and Edelu, Getty Images, in early December. A secret tunnel was discovered in New York, leading to the main synagogue of the Jewish religious movement Chabad Lubavitch in Brooklyn. The Crown Heights regional newspaper reported this. A local resident told reporters that he heard suspicious sounds at night. The building, located at 770 Eastern Boulevard, is considered the world headquarters of the organization, which welcomes thousands of visitors each year, including international students and religious leaders. The synagogue previously served as the home of the head of the Hasidic movement in the 1940s, Yosef Yitzhak Schneerson, over the years. Additional buildings were erected on the site as the movement grew in size. After the tunnel was discovered, the synagogue's leadership called in civil engineers to fill in the secret underground passages. However, on Monday, January 8th, a group of young people began to protest and defend the tunnel. Someone called the police, after which clashes broke out between her and the Orthodox youth for several hours. Police asked people to move away from the tunnel entrance, eyewitnesses said. After they refused, law enforcement officers began making arrests, as 21-year-old Baruch Dahan said. When those present saw one of the protesters being handcuffed, a stampede began. The community feels terrible. It's a shame, Dahan said. NBC News writes that police arrested 12 in the city as a result. Amy wrote on their they are accused of causing harm, endangering, and obstructing government administration. Three more received reports on petty hooliganism. Who dug the tunnel and why? Chabad Lubavitch is an Orthodox Hasidic Jewish organization. About 200,000 Hasidim live in New York, which is only a part of the city's Jewish population. The purpose and origin of the tunnel that caused the clashes are still unclear. But there is reason to believe that its construction was the result of an ongoing dispute between the Chabad Lubavitch community and a more radical group. Witnesses said several tunnel defenders told them they wanted to expand the community. The Chabad publication Kaliv News notes that the students who tried to stop the filling of the tunnel were mostly from Israel. They, according to journalists, are associated with the Messianic wing of Chabad, which believes that the leader of the Lubavitcher movement, Rabbi Menachem Mendel Schneerson, is not dead and is the Messiah. The main Chabad movement rejects this claim. In 2006, a court ruled that the main Chabad controlled the synagogue building at 770 Eastern Boulevard. According to the Jewish Gazette, about 6 months ago, a group of yeshiva students affiliated with the Messianic movement began digging tunnels to gain unauthorized access to the building. When Chabad leaders learned of a network of tunnels that could compromise the integrity of the buildings, they called in a cement truck to fill them in. The Times of Israel writes that construction of the tunnel took place over several years. As the publication notes, the video footage shows that an underground passage leads to an abandoned mikveh ritual bath. Journalists also noticed that the tunnel was filled with rubbish and household items, such as a mattress and a high chair. Chabad spokesman Moti Seligson said that extremist students some time ago broke through several walls in the area adjacent to the synagogue to provide unauthorized access there. He also added that when a cement truck was about to repair these walls, extremists broke through the synagogue wall, destroying the sanctuary in an attempt to maintain unauthorized access. This is obviously deeply distressing to the Chabad Lubavitch movement and the Jewish community around the world. We hope and pray that it will be possible to quickly restore the decent appearance of this holy place, Seligson wrote on Twitter. He said the synagogue building is closed until a structural safety review is completed, according to the AP. A spokesman for the movement also suggests that the underground passage began in the basement of an empty apartment building behind the headquarters, passed under a number of offices and lecture halls, and eventually connected to the synagogue. He called the construction of the secret tunnel a fraudulent act of vandalism committed by a group of misguided young men. The chairman of Chabad Lubavitch, Rabbi Yehuda Krinsky, also condemned the act of vandalism committed by the young people. These odious actions will be investigated, and the sanctity of the synagogue will be restored. We thank the New York Police Department for its professionalism and sensitivity, he said.